So you might be in a position where for some reason your PlayStation 4 controller just has a bunch of joystick drift and you're trying to figure out what's going on there. So basically what happens is your controller occasionally can go ahead and get some sort of drift going on in the background, and that can be very, very annoying. So the first thing you want to do is see, you know, did you recently throw your controller? Did you recently drop your controller really hard? Or did you recently spill something in your controller? Those things you can't really fix with the method I'm going to show you. You're either going to have to completely, you know, get your controller exchanged. You're going to have to take it apart and fix it that way. The way I'm going to show you doesn't actually include that. One of the things you can do, though, is kind of go around your specific joystick like this. And what you can try doing is going through and actually blowing or getting a can of compressed air and blowing inside of each little, you know, corner. So put it this way, blow into this side, same exact thing on this side, top and the bottom, and see if that ends up freeing any dust or anything up like that. If it's a broken component you have in here, that's not going to fix it. But if you actually have kind of somewhat of like a bunch of dust or debris or a lot of whatever remnants of chips and stuff inside of here, that may actually end up freeing some things out. But another thing you may want to try is using a little bit of isopropyl alcohol. So this is basically rubbing alcohol. You can get it. You probably already have it in your house. Now, a lot of people have had such good success with using something like this. So what you can try doing is you can go and grab some sort of like cloth of some sort, open your specific isopropyl alcohol up, and put just a little bit on it. You don't want to submerge this inside of isopropyl alcohol. You just want to put a tiny bit on it. And when you do that, all you want to do there is you want to go ahead and kind of rub it inside. I probably wouldn't recommend using this thing, maybe like a cotton swab of some sort, and kind of rubbing a little bit inside of there. Now, you do not want to water damage your controller, so don't go overboard. You can do it on both sides, actually, so go ahead and do them on exactly the both sides like I mentioned. Make sure everything inside is, you know, not submerged with water, and that may end up fixing the problem as well. Again, that's not a guarantee, but it's another thing you can try doing, and that's basically what I would recommend doing in that case. So that pretty much covers it up. If you have any other thoughts or questions, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out.